إن شاء الله محاضرة بعنوان The Art of Sin. تفضل يا باشمهندس.
Hello everyone and I hope all is well. My name is محمود فرج رضوان. I'll talking about one of the great topics in oil and gas industry and the loving memory of Dr. يحيى محمد النادي as a professor of drilling engineering in Al-Azhar University. I have the honor to be a part of this free webinar. This webinar titled with The Art of Cement. We will go through the following outlines, starting from overview about the cement and what about the importance and the benefits of the successful cement job, and what about the job challenges. Then we will go through the mud removal, and we will go through the primary cementing process, and what about the cement process aspects or segments. We will talking about one of the main critical problem in the cement process is the gas migration control. And then we'll go through the squeeze cement process. And finally, we'll talking about the cement quality and the integrity evaluation. We will start with an overview about the cement process. Cementing is a critical part of any well design, construction, completion, and subsequently well integrity management system. Whenever we construct or drill an oil or gas well, we use cement for our operations. Now, we will illustrate what about the high quality cementing objectives. The high quality cementing objectives is to support the pipe in place for further drilling operation and for production operation. The second objective is to protect the pipe in place for any corrosive formation fluids. The third objective is the hydraulic isolation for no communication between different formation fluids, and also for no migration of fluid of formation to surface, and also to prevent the loss of production to sieve zone or any cross flow inside the reservoir. So we can summarize what about or why the cement is important in our upstream operation. For three topics or for three reasons. As mechanical well integrity during the drilling operation to isolate the weak formation and structural support of any well drilling operation. Also for production optimization to optimize the stimulation treatment and to optimize the production from the well throughout the lifetime of production. Also, the last important reason for reservoir isolation and protection, as the cement will isolate any unwanted fluid to produce with the main fluid or main hydrocarbon fluid, oil or gas. When we are talking about the art of cement, we have talking about the well cementing challenges. Well, cementing challenges starting from the borehole condition, the bore mud condition, the bore centralization, the loss circulation problem, the abnormal pressure and subnormal pressure, and the high temperature. All these challenges will lead the cement job to be unsuccessful job. But when we are talking about the art of cement, we will start from the one of the critical aspects in the cement process or a cement job. This is the mud removal. The ideal well bore casing is starting from you have to cure any losses and you have to cure any flow from your formation. Also, you have to get a gauge diameter to be a uniform hole as possible or as you can with no washouts or tight spots and the shale problem for swelling or sloughing for shale to be identified and prevented. And also the casing to be centered in a borehole and also to have an accurate data about the bottom hole static temperature and bottom hole circulation temperature. As you know that the bottom hole static temperature at top of cement is have to be more than the bottom hole circulation temperature at the total depth. Also the annular gap to be minimum from 3-4 inch ideal to 1.5 inch as the annular gap between the wellbore and the casing. So the mud removal is one of the most important aspects of a cement job. The mud removal process consists of three steps. The first one is the hole cleaning. The second one, the conditioning, the drilling fluid. And the last one is to displace the drilling fluid from the annulus. When we are talking about the mud removal, we start from the well preparation. The well preparation, especially start from drill with good mud properties or mud rheology to have a thin filter cakes and low flat gel strengths and to drill an engage hole to be avoid any ununiform hole and also the washout problem and tight spots and to drill a smooth hole with minimal dogleg severity and also to maintain the wellbore stability and to clean any cutting from hole as the hole cleaning is very important for any fluid pumped into your formation or inside your reservoir. So the wiper trips is very important and controlling the mud rheology properties for transportation is very important as the well preparation. The well preparation job starting from hole cleaning, you have to control and optimize your mud properties. And also the wiper trips is very important. And also the caliber log is have a great benefit to define what about the hole condition and what about the volume of cement you are determined and calculated it as excess factor or excess volume you need it in your cement job. The second phase is the conditioning your mud, as you have to control what about the gel strength, what about the plastic viscosity, what about the solids in your drilling process, and also to determine what about the mud pressure gradient to find what about the minimum rate for all around the flow in your process. Then the last process or the third one is to displace mud from annulus to start your cement job operation. And you have to optimize your slurry placement using casing centralization to be optimized as the standoff or casing standoff to be more than 75%. And the casing movement is very important in your case. When we are talking about the mud removal, we are talking about the circulating and conditioning process. You have to circulate minimum one whole volume, and you have to break the gel strands, and you have to lower the rheology properties as much as practical, as yield point to be from 8 to 10 pound per 100 square feet, and no bright sag if you have a bright in your mud system or in your drilling fluid system. Also, to lower your drill solids and to be satisfied with the mud pressure gradient requirements and try for 100% circulation efficiency and to have a good hole cleaning in your process and verify what about your hole condition using a caliber look. So the fluid calibers is to determine the circulation efficiency or amount of fluid is moving in the multi-arm open hole caliber lug and determine the total hole geometry and total hole volume. And the second step to circulate at cementing rate and determine what about the mud pump efficiency and to drop marker or tracer in stages or in intervals. And the monitoring process of return for marker and the calculation of the certain volume or circulating volume should be calculated as a mechanical caliber volume determined it or identified it. And the last step is to increase the rate and recalculate the efficiency or the circulation efficiency. So the criteria for effective mud removal starting from a casing moved using wiper plugs and top plugs, also using washers and spacers, also to select the proper flow regime in your cement job operation. As you know that we have two main types of flow regimes, laminar flow and turbulent flow, and the transition zone between laminar and turbulent flow. The laminar and turbulent flow regimes are found anywhere by concentric or eccentric outside the hole. So the best method to identify what about the flow regime is the Reynolds number. The Reynolds number is a dimensionless number to predict the flow regime depends on what about what about the type of your fluid, Newtonian fluid or non-Newtonian fluid. This is the equation for the Reynolds number for Newtonian fluid. And the second one is the equation for the Reynolds number for non-Newtonian fluid. The turbulent flow achieved when critical Reynolds number is reached. So the flow regime comparison, as you see in this picture, if you have a centered casing or centered annulus, the turbulent flow will distributed all over the cross section of the concentric casing and the cement will be homogeneous in this process. If you have an eccentric casing to be not in the center or in the homogeneous process, so you must to be have two types of flow regime, turbulent here and laminar flow for the low side of the casing. Sometimes you have to utilize the simulator to predict or to analyze what about the laminar placement in your process, and also to identify what about the cement bypassing the mud on the narrow side or the low side. And this process or this problem will be due to the poor centralization of casing. So in drilling industry or in the upstream industry, we utilize many types of centralizers, depends on what about the application, what about your hole, and depends on some factors regarding the manufacture process or the manufacture mechanism of any type of centralizers, starting from the bow spring or spiral type or straight type. This is a flexible bow spring. The centralizer OD slightly larger than the open hole size. The second type is the right bow or positive type. This is an unflexible outside diameter type and slightly less than previous casing ID and use inside cased hole sections and also effective in engage open hole section. The third type is the rigid solid or slip-on type. This type of bow used as bare rigid type. So the centralization effect is very important. In real life, we aim to achieve a minimum standoff or a minimum casing standoff of 75% to 80%. Is considered to be good for our cement operation. And this is modified by the cement company using the computer software or the simulator software for the cement design process. So if you see here, when you are put the casing in center, the standoff of 100%. If you put your casing without any centralizers or any proper centralization, you have an centralized casing and your standoff will be 0%. So the reciprocation is very important. What about the reciprocation process? Reciprocation is a movement of casing up and down during the cement job. This operation must be done from the start of circulation to end of displacement. The speed will be 20 to 40 feet stroke, and you have a number of cycle to be 1 to 5 minutes per cycle. And to sometimes needs scratchers to be effective. And the casing may become stuck during movement. So the excessive swab and surge pressure may be created. And you cannot be the only method of mud removal. So the reciprocation is one of the important method for the good mud removal. Also the rotation. Is very important. The rotation is considered as a circular movement of pipe and must be done from the start of circulation to end of placement, 10 to 40 RPM. Scratchers help the circulating efficiency. And sometimes you need a special rotary cement heads and power swivels to achieve the rotation move to the rotation process. Also, the using of scratchers is very important for mud removal and for the circulation efficiency. In the oil and gas industry, we have two types of scratchers, the reciprocation type and the rotation type. The most effective and well-centralized casing will depend on your condition. And you have to establish a circulation barrier to cementing job. The one of the important part of the mud removal is the cement wiper plugs. The cement wiper plugs to keep fluids separate in casing and to reduce the contamination. we have two types of plugs, the bottom plugs, to remove mud ahead of cement and to prevent cement falling through lighter fluid ahead. And we are using two or more if possible. The top plugs have a function to separate cement from displacing fluid, and the positive indication of end of displacement process. This is an example of industrial rubber cement fiber plugs with different types, as bottom and top plugs utilized in your cement job. But the question now is, why run a bottom plug? The bottom plug wipes accumulated mud cake, scale, and so on from inner casing walls out through float equipment into the annulus. And also the volume of debris can be significant and the fill up short track if not removed ahead of the top plug. So we have a very important events to be recorded during the mud removal process. This events starting from what about the mud condition, rate and time, and how many centralizers we run and where, and also what about the recommended practice of the number of centralizers we are using in any hole size, and also what about the casing rotation or reciprocation? And also what about the plugs correctly dropped and achieve the function of any type? And also what about the rheology and density of the spacer fluid? And also what about the correct volume of pre-flush? We utilize the pre-flush in the starting of mud removal process. The also any change in flow rate, density, and also any stop of pressure peaks is very important in to be recorded and will have a great effect in the mud removal process. So the effective mud removal conclusions, as you have to condition your mud barrier to cement process, and you have to utilize the centralization to give optimum casing standoff to be from 75% to 80% as to be good, have a good cement job in this case, and to rotate and or reciprocate casing, also to use the bottom plugs to sometimes the two types is preferred in your case, and to optimize the slurry placement using turbulent flow preferred or effective laminar flow techniques. Utilize the simulator or the software for simulate this process. Sometimes you have to use the chemical wash as a pre-flush and some types of carbonate rocks or the a whole condition with a bad condition. And to control, what about the mud spacer or cement slurry properties? In this type or in this case, you have to utilize a batch mixer and to identify the mixing for cement or mixing of any fluid to be achieved by batch mixer, not to be on fly, and the compatibility of mud cement spacer with lab and the fluid test is very important. The second topic or the second item in the cement operation to be the primary cementing. When we are talking about the primary cementing, We will identify what about the types of casing. We have a lot of types of casing or different types of casing, starting from conductor, surface casing, intermediate casing, reduction casing, and the last one is a liner. We have to identify what about the purpose or function of any type of casing. Conductor is to prevent washing out under the rig and also to provide elevation for flow nipple. The common sizes and depths for conductor is from 30 inch to 20 inch welded or 20 inch to 16 inch threaded. And the recommended depths or the common depths to be from 30 feet to 200 feet or less than 100 feet is a common in our drilling process. Also, you have to identify what about the pumping practice and what about the large excess. You have to identify or calculate it in your cement job. And to identify what about the BOBs. In this case, BOBs not unusually connected. And what about the cement process in this case? We have two types of cement methodology. Starting the first one is the throw drill pipe cementing. The throw drill pipe cementing have key points starting from the cement contamination, cement and challenging, channeling, also the displacement process, and you have to bump until the cement reach to surface as we define it as a top cement job. The second type is the outside cementing, is to bring the cement to surface. In this type, we have to utilize a macaroni tubing string. And this case have to identify the maximum depths will be from 250 to 300 feet. And also this process is very important to identify the high friction pressures and it's not a standard connections for this process. The second type of casing is a surface casing. Surface casing is to protect surface freshwater formations and cases of unconsolidated or lost circulation areas and to support the subsequent casing string like intermediate and production casing. And provides the primary pressure control as a BOB support. In this case, the surface casing common sizes and depths starting from 20 inch to 9.58 inch threaded, and the depths starting from 100 to 3000 feet in this case. The surface casing cementing have to identify what about the excess volume of cement. And also you have to recommend this through drill pipe method to save your cement volume and to save your rig time. The common cement type in this case, sometimes we have to utilize the lead light cement slurries with high yield strengths. And also sometimes we have to utilize the neat tail slurries with good compressive strengths. And at any types of this cement, you have to reduce the weight on cement to a minimum with accelerators. So in a surface casing, the BOB configuration is to be utilized and to be installed in your operation. As the BOBs starting from the annular preventer, and also the mud outlet line, and also the rig floor connection, and the BOB's ram starting from blind rams, shear rams, pipe rams. This is a very important to utilize a BOB in your process and to control any blowout or any kick from the near subsurface formation or a near subsurface zone in your drilling operation. The third type of casing is the intermediate casing. The intermediate casing is to separate the hole into workable sections from the loss circulation problem, the salt section or the salt zones, also from the over-pressurized zones, and also from the heaving shales or swelling shales. The common sizes and depths for the intermediate casing starting from 13.38 inch, 10.34 inch, 9.58 inch, and the depths ranged between 3,000 feet to 10,000 feet. So the intermediate casing have to cemented to surface or to previous casing show. And sometimes you have to utilize two cement stage job. And in this case, you have to apply the good cement practices, and you have to identify what about the cement volume and what about the excess volume. The common type of cement in this case is typically filter slurries followed by high compressive tail. And sometimes you have to utilize a specialized light, heavy, salt, saturated cement. This is will depends on your condition and depends on what about the lithology and what about the formation problem in your case. When we are talking about the intermediate casing, we are talking about a two-stage cementing process. The two-stage cementing process have a key points, is a separation and isolation of zones, and to reduce the hydrostatic required in this case, and can leave zone in the annulus uncemented as cement at total depths and surface. As you see here, this is the first stage and followed by the second stage process. In this case, you have to identify this process as a two-stage cementing process. The one of the main type of casing is the production casing. Production casing is to isolate the bay zone or the production zone from other formations and the fluids in them. Also, to protective housing for production equipment, like subsurface artificial lift and multiple zone completion. And sometimes it's have a purpose to utilize as a screens for sand control and to cover the worn or damaged intermediate string. The common size for production casing starting from 4.5 inch, 5 inch, 7 inch, and 9.58 inch. The last type of casing is a liners. The liner is a casing, but not reach the surface. The liners have a key points as require less casing with optimized cost and utilize in a deeper wells, and also have a small annular clearance. This is will be a great effect in the cement volume calculation. And also you have to apply the recommended practice and to apply a special treatment procedures. And you have to utilize a specialized equipment in this case, as the clearance is very small, and also the flow regime for cement process and for mud removal is very important in this case. When you are talking about the casing, we have to identify what about the casing specs. The EBI casing specs, starting from the outside diameter, the weight or a nominal weight, and the grade, and also the burst pressure and collapse pressure and the thread type. The casing properties or casing specs is very important to be identified in a casing problem, in a casing program, and also to have identify what about the burst pressure, what about the collapse pressure, and what about the tensile strength or tensile load in your case. This is, will have a great effect in the cement design. Also, the thread types is very important, as the connections or the thread types will have a special handling process, like the special type of thread, like a gas seal thread, like a VAM thread, or the special type of hydril or batteries, or the ABI thread. All of these types, you have to identify it, and you have to consider it in your cement design process and your connections utilized and the process in running casing. When we are talking about the running casing process, the running casing process, starting from the inspection of casing, also to prepare your whole condition, as the mud condition is very important and the clearance is very important, and the running process itself, as you have to utilize the specialized equipment for running casing, and you have to running casing in a too fast and in a very fast time for to prevent any problem regarding the whole condition, and also regarding the mobile salt and the swelling shear. So we have many types of cement, starting from the class A, class B, class C, and for a constant or a special type, you have to identify what about the mix water volume in gallon per sack, and we have to identify what about the slurry weight in pound per gallon, and the recommended depths to utilize this type of cement, and also the range for the bottom hole static temperature in this case. And sometimes you have to utilize a special type of cement. If you have a high pressure or a high temperature well, and also if you have a very critical condition for your reservoir. So one of the main item in cement process is the cement additives. The cement additives is very important, as the cement additives is a specific materials for optimum cement performance, starting from the low circulation additive, the accelerators, the lightweight cement, the fluid loss, also the gas migration control additive or gas block, also the defoamers and dispersants, and also the expansion additive and the heavyweight additive or chemicals, and also the retarders. All of these groups of additives have a great effect in the performance of cement and also in the success rate of your cement job. When we are talking about the cement job procedures, you have to identify what about the pre-job process and what about the operation process itself. The pre-job starting from check your calculations with drilling supervisor or company man, and also the rig up for the cementing pump and all the high pressure lines and all equipment you applied in your case, and also to check any chemicals or materials, utilize the material safety data sheet, and also to held a safety and organization meeting and prepare the mixing fluids, spacers, and washers. The second stage is the job procedures itself. The job starting from test the high pressure lines or the pump lines. And the second one is the load the bottom and top plugs. The third step is to pump washes and spacers. The fourth one is to drop the bottom plug. The fifth one is to mix and pump cement. The sixth one is to drop top plug and to displace and pump down plug and check the returns, if any, in your process. This figure will illustrate the one stage primary cement job for a surface casing, starting from the circulating process of mud and the process for the bumping wash, spacer, and cement slurry, and to continue displacement process and the end of job. To identify this process as a step-by-step, you have to follow this pictures. We're starting from the casing cement relation using or utilizing the float coolers here and the float show. Float coolers is at the top and the float show at the bottom. And the second step is to displace or circulate to condition the your mud. The third one is to bumping a spacer fluid ahead the mud. And the then bumping lead cement and the drop bottom plug as to continue bumping lead cement and drop the bottom plug as this picture illustrated this process. And also to continue the bumping lead cement till you bumping the tail cement and continue with drop top plug and start displacing with a spacer and continue displacing process. And the last step to plug down and check the return at surface. In this case, your job is complete and you have to wait in your cement for a time. This time you have to identify it and predict it using the analysis for lab test. But when we are talking a cement process, we have to identify what about the main stages or main process element. When we are talking about the cement process, we have three main parts or three main processes, starting from the job design. The job design, as you have to gathering all data, like the borehole geometry, like the temperature gradient, the problem zones, loss circulation, washouts, water flow, and so on. Also, you have to identify what about the survey data, like a true vertical depth and the kickoff point, and also the deviation, the deviation survey and Doeglick severity if you have in your hole. Also, the mud rheology. The second step and job design process is a lab verification as the cement material or cement fluid is to be suitable for downhole condition, and the cement additives are to be suitable for downhole condition also, and the cement system is to be predictable, and the simulation process is very important. So the third step in the job design process is the cement job simulation. This is will be using a computer software or the analysis for cement. And also it's a very important to identify what about the operation procedures, and this is will be identified as a job execution. The job execution is to reproduce the cement system verified by the lab test and to achieve the effective hole cleaning and mud removal, and to identify what about the duration of cement placement and what about the pressure bumping performance and the job sequence for bumping any type of cement. The last process or the third cementing process is the job evaluation. The job evaluation, as you know, that the cement have to be support the pipe and also to create a hydraulic isolation, and the cement to be distributed all over the section you target on it on or focused on it, and to identify what about the cement success rate and what about the your further action if you have to apply any squeeze cement, as we will illustrate in the next slides. This is the typical cement equipment in a land rig, starting from the cement pump and cement tanks, and also the flow lines and the pump lines, also the sacks for cement and for additives. This process is a very critical and also is a very important for any well cement design. You have to identify what about the water volumes or what about your water needs. You have to identify with more water in your cement system, you have to achieve a lower density and lower viscosity. But you also have to achieve a longer working time and also to achieve a lower compressive strength and a higher permeability. For this case or for this process, you have to remember that the good slurry properties not mean at any time is a good mechanical process. Good slurry properties does not mean a good mechanical properties for your cement. So you have to identify what about the cement slurry testing. As per EBI RB 10B part 2, you have to identify or determine the rheology properties for your cement. And also you have to identify the fluid loss of your cement at different temperature and different condition, especially for gas formation. And also to lab test the free fluid loss, and also to determine what about the settling or stability testing, and also to identify what about the spacer testing. The spacer is very important to be testing for compatibility with cement and mud as per ABI 10B part 2. One of the main important challenges in your cement process is a gas migration control, especially in a gas wells or in oil wells with high gas oil ratio. The gas migration is the invasion of formation fluids into the annulus due to a pressure imbalance of the formation phase. This process is considered as, or titled as, a loss of hydrostatic pressure. As you know that, if you have a formation pressure is larger than the hydrostatic pressure, the gas will migrate in this case. So the consequences of this problem, the first one is the poor zone isolation. Sometimes you lose your production, and also sometimes you have an overpressure shallow formation fluids. And one of the main consequences of this process is the blowout. And also one of the main consequences of the gas migration is to repair required like safety and regulations, as you have to identify what about the damaged well equipment, the squeezed cement job required, the casing corrosion, and the efficiency of your cement or your circulation process. And also one of the main consequences is the environmental damage due to the blowout or due to the freshwater aquifers at surface. But we have to identify the problem for gas migration. What about the path of gas or for gas in your cement process? One of the main reason for path of gas is a channel. A channel is a failure to effectively displace the drilling fluid. Also, the invasion during cement placement due to the insufficient or excessive loss of hydrostatic pressure in your cement job. The third one is to set a cement failure. This failure at the cement to casing and or cement to formation interface, as the connectivity or the bond between the casing, cement, and formation is not a very bonded or not achieved as a success rate. So the gas will define above for migration, and you have to identify this process. The buses of gas as the channel can be caused by the failure to effectively displace the drilling fluid. So the mud removal is very important in a gas well. Also is very important if you have a gas migration problem. Also, the invasion of hydrostatic loss when the cement is in fluid and the transition state. The fluid loss during and after placement due to the chemical shrinkage, due to the temperature, or due to the gel strength development or free fluid or fluid loss property, and also the highly permeable slurry. The fluid loss is very important, as the recommended fluid loss in your case will be identify the success rate of your cement job, and also to identify what about your problem of gas migration, and you have to control it in your cement operation. The cement, the setting of cement failure may crack or debonding the cement. This is will be identified for many reasons, like downhole stresses, a change in temperature, a change in pressure, and also the poor interfacial bonding as a microannulus in your cement. As these pictures will identify this, sometimes people identify this as the cracks or debond in your cement. So you have to achieve a good mud removal as it's a key factor in the prevention or control of gas migration. As centralization also is very important, also the condition of mud to follow the density and the viscosity hierarchy. Also the bio-movement during placement is very important, and the displacement regime and rate and the spacers or pre-flush fluid is very important. So when we are talking about the ideal slurry properties to minimize or to prevent the gas migration during the cement setting, we have two types two stages. During the placement, you have to identify the suitable or proper rheology properties for mud and spacer removal. And also you have to identify what about the fluid loss to be less than 50 milliliter per 30 minutes. And the second stage is the after placement process. As in this case, you have to identify or achieve the low fluid loss to avoid early gelation of cement, and also to identify what about the poor throat plugging materials, and to achieve the short transition time from 100 to 500 pound per 100 feet square. The gas migration control is a very critical problem in cement operation. So you have to identify the methods for prevention for problem like this. The methods for prevention of gas migration, starting from the enhancement or improvement of cement placement practices, and to identify what about the cement slurry optimization, and to achieve the low gel strength development slurries, and to achieve the short transition time, and to use a gas migration block additive in your process. So one of the main approaches or main methodology to identify what about the gas migration problem, to utilize the gas flow analyzer to take a slurry or a sample of your slurry and put it in this approach or in this device, and to identify what about the gas flow with time and what about the shrinkage factor or shrinkage effect due to the temperature and the pressure change after the cement placement. In this slide, we will identify what about the successful cementing of gas wells. The gas migration control is a complex problem with a corresponding hierarchy of solutions, starting from mud removal, set cement mechanical properties, cement slurry design, cement hydration process, and also to identify what about the fluid density and the fluid loss control. At any time, the important rule here is the prevention is better than curing at any case. Sometimes you don't have to achieve or you don't reach to a successful cement job. So in this case, you have to apply a squeeze cement job. This squeeze cement job have a definition like this photo or this picture to identify or to define what about the squeeze cement process. The squeeze cement is the injection of cement slurry into perforation or casing leaks or channels. Below or above the fracture pressure. So the application for squeeze cement is the primary cement job repair. It's a very important application for the squeeze cement. Also, the zonal isolation for any water shutoff or gas shutoff or any zonal isolation problem. Also, in zone abandonment process, if you have to plug and abandon any formation or any zone, or you have to temporary abandon any zone, you have to utilize, in this case, the squeeze cement or apply the squeeze cement job. Also, one of the main applications here is the casing leaks and loss circulation problem. In the squeeze cement, you have to identify what is the basic concept in this process. The basic concept is defined or identified as a filtration process, as you have to define and achieve the filtration process to be applied for the differential pressure and to be achieved in a porous media, and also to identify what about the filter cake deposition. In this case, the filtration process is a very important or a very critical in the successful of the squeeze cement. So the effect of fluid loss control in a squeeze cement job is very important. As you see here, in this side, you have a completely bridged casing. In this picture, or in this side of picture, you have a partially bridged casing. And in this case, you have a completely field perforations. And in this case, you have a partially field perforations. So the effect of fluid loss control in a squeeze cement job is a very critical and very important. When we are talking about the process of cement squeeze treatment, you have to identify four steps or four segments of the treatment. Starting from the job planning, you have to determine the problem and reason to squeeze, and to analyze the wellbore conditions, and to select the suitable squeeze technique. The second stage or the second phase is the design process, to select the proper squeeze tools, and also to select all other fluids utilized in your process, like perforation, fluids, perforating fluids, acids, cement spacer, completion fluids, and also to design the cement slurry volume to curing your problem, and also to prepare a detailed job procedures. The third phase is the execution process, to prepare the wellbore and the clean all voids to be squeezed, and to set the squeeze tools at the desired locations, and to set the equipment and mix the slurry in a proper way, and also to place the cement and apply the squeeze pressure, and to allow the enough wait on cement time to test or log the squeeze job. The fourth process or the fourth step in the cement squeeze process is the evaluation. The evaluation is to perform a positive and negative pressure test, and also to perform a cement evaluation job. The cement evaluation log in the squeeze cement is a very important. When you are talking about the execution process of the squeeze cement, you have to identify the different types of squeeze techniques or cement squeeze techniques. The cement squeeze techniques have three main types regarding the placement methodology, the bumping methodology, and the application methodology. When we are talking about the squeeze techniques as the placement technique or placement methodology, The placement type two have two types, low pressure and high pressure. And the pumping methodology have two types, the running methodology and hesitation type. And the application will be divided into two types, the bread and head types and the squeeze tools type. When we are talking about the low pressure squeeze, the low pressure squeeze is identified as a squeeze pressure below fracture pressure. And the volume of a slurry is small in this case. And you have to apply a special precautions in your job. The second type of the methodology of placement is the hydrostatic pressure, is the high pressure squeeze. The high pressure squeeze identified as a squeeze pressure above fracture pressure. And in this case, we are using a large slurry volume. And also we have to identify a special precautions in this case. The running squeeze methodology depends on the continuous pumping process and final squeeze pressure attained. And in this case, we have to apply a low or high pressure squeeze and use a large slurry volumes. This is a running squeeze process starting from the low volume and reached to a large slurry volume depends on the low or high pressure squeeze methodology utilized. The hesitation process is identified or defined as an intermittent pumping process. Use a low pump rates and high initial leakoff, and use a small slurry volumes with a long job times. So the hesitation process is not one stage, but is an intermittent pumping stages and utilize a low pump rate and also utilize a small slurry volume, but the time so for job is too long. The also one of the main types of the squeeze cement job is the bread and head squeeze. The bread and head squeeze is achieved by a bore buoy squeeze like this picture. And in this case, no downhole tools, the exposed casing and well head on surface, as the bumping and cement, bumping of cement is achieved by bumping at pressure, at a certain pressure from surface. The job procedures is very important in this case. And also you have to identify what about the squeeze tool techniques. Sometimes you have to identify the squeeze tool techniques for your job. You have to identify the two types of squeeze tools, the retrievable tools or the drillable tools. The retrievable tools as the positive packer or the retrievable bridge plug system, or a slurry squeeze, a shorty squeeze tool. And the second type of squeeze tool techniques is a drillable tools. Drillable tools like a cement retainer and the drillable bridge plug. These two type of squeeze tools have an application and also have a certain job procedures and have a certain methodology for each type. Also, one of the main type of squeeze is the coiled tubing squeeze. The coiled tubing squeeze is applied in the producing wells and the through tubing operation. The coiled tubing squeeze have an advantage is cost is very low and Also, you have to achieve the accurate placement, but the design of this process is very critical. And the coiled tubing, you have to identify what about the retarders, what about the wet and cement time, what about the bumping procedures and the bumping steps. It's a very important for coiled tubing squeeze. So when we are talking about the factors limiting the squeeze success in narrow gaps, particles must be 3 to 5 times smaller than gap. In this case, the cement slurry must have low viscosity for placement pressures and excellent fluid loss control. And to set cement in this case, you have to achieve a high compressive strength for your cement and also a high shear bond strength and low permeability type of cement. Sometimes the squeeze cement identify a special type of cement and also a special additives to achieve the success in the squeeze cement job operation and also to limit the factors to limit the operation challenges in this case. When you are talking about the recap or conclusion of the cement job, you have to identify what about the cement job guidelines. The cement job guidelines, starting from the first step, is don't allow the mud to deteriorate while drilling the section. And to condition the mud, if required, barrier pulling out to run casing. The second step is to keep the casing centralized during the job. The third step, or the third guidelines, is to have a technically good spacer plan. The fourth step, or the fourth guideline, is to design the cement slurry in a proper way. Also, the fifth one is to displace with the optimum bump rates as per simulation results. The sixth one is to prevent cement or mud contamination, and also to know what about the formation fracture limits. It's a very important, especially when you apply a squeeze cement in high pressure if you apply a cement process in a high pressure value. The last step or the last guideline is to rotate the liners whenever possible to achieve or to get a success cement job. The last topic in our presentation today is the cement quality or integrity evaluation. When you are talking about the cement quality or integrity evaluation, we have to identify two types of methodology we utilize in cement quality or integrity evaluation. The first one or the first type is a non-petrophysical methods. The non-petrophysical methods is defined as some parameters or some factors like surface cement samples, collect surface cement samples, and to pressure or rate or density record. Also, the observation of return of cement is very important, and the pressure test is very important also, and the leak of test or formation integrity test is very important to identify and to determine what about the quality of your cement and what about the integrity for your cement operation. The second methodology is a petrophysical methodology. Sometimes people identify this method as a logging methodology. Utilize the temperature log, a neutral log, or acoustic logs like the famous Sonic Log is a CBL VDL. CBL VDL is a abbreviation for cement to bond log and variable density log. The second type of acoustic logs is ultrasonic log. And sometimes companies preferred to run a combination log between CBL VDL and also ultrasonic log. When we are talking about the non-petrophysical method, we are talking about the cement show bond integrity test. You have to identify test as, in this case, you have to draw or identify what about the relation between the bumping pressure and the bumping rate. In this case, you have to identify what about the steps or what about the stages for the cement show bond integrity test to assure the cement show or the show bond is very aggressive and will achieve the isolation and mechanical barrier for the well life cycle during production, during completion, and so on. Also, one of the main assessment for the quality of a cement job as a non-petrophysical method is to identify a cement job quality assessment sheet like this. This sheet identifies some parameters of cement job regarding the well information and the preparation process, and also the execution process, and what about the completion or the final execution process, and also the HSE, health safety and environment issues. This assessment sheet have a score or a points for any topic or for any issue in your cement job, and you have to achieve the quality adjustment factor as the sheet. This is one of the main tool to assess the quality of your cement job and to identify what about the integrity of your cement. The second type of the cement evaluation methodology is the petrophysical method. The petrophysical method will defined as some types of logs like temperature logs, noise log, and the acoustic logs. In our presentation, we will focus in the acoustic log as it's a very common and very important in our process. Starting from the CBL VDL log, CBL VDL represents one of the main logging tool to identify what about the cement bond log and what about the variable density log. In cement bond log or in VDL or variable density log, the tool configuration, as you see here, consists of one transmitter and two receivers. One of the first receiver is a 3 feet receiver for cement bond log measurement. And the second one is a 5 feet receiver for VDL or variable density log analysis. The CBL or cement bond log is the amplitude of first arrival in millivolt or microvolt. And the function of casing cement bond is measured by CBL. The variable density log or VDL identify or measure the time in microsecond and function of casing cement bond and cement. This will achieve also the function of casing cement bond and cement formation bond. So the sonic measurements in CBL VDL have a main function or a main purpose to identify and evaluate of tubular solid formation bonding. The benefits to utilize the CBL VDL as this logs works in a wide range of wellbore fluids and densities and have a less affected by dry microannulus than ultrasonic. So the limitations for CBL VDL, it's very affected by the well microannulus and also sensitive to the eccentric for casing. We are talking about the eccentricity of casing and the standoff of casing standoff factor or percentage. Also affected by the fast formation. The fast formation have a great challenge or a great problem with the CBL VDL, as the CBL VDL, like a sonic wave, this sonic wave like ringing a bell. Ringing a bell will depend on what about the transmitting time and what about the receiving time. In fast formation, the signal transmitted, returned in a fast time and a very fast time, and the CBL VDL in this case will not identify what about the cement bond, what about the cement casing bond, and what about the cement formation bond. So the interpretation hence in this case, identify what about the type of bond, what about the CBL amplitude we will achieve in this case, and what about the VDL value. The free pipe, as example, free pipe, as you have a no cement in this area, so you have a free pipe, the CBL amplitude is very high, and the casing arrival is large, but the formation arrival is very weak, or you have non-formation arrival in this case. The second type of bond in CBL VDL is a good casing to cement to formation bond. In this case, the CBL amplitude is very low, and the casing arrival is weak, and the formation arrival is strong. If you have a good casing bond, but you have a poor formation bond, you have a low CBL amplitude, but you have a casing arrival weak, and you have a formation arrival is very weak. So you have also to identify the fast formation arrivals. The fast formation arrivals in CBL is high, and the casing arrival is absent, and the formation arrival is, as the formation is a fast formation, so the amplitude or the formation arrival in VDL is very strong. When we are running the CBL VDL, you have to identify what about the cement bond log values. The cement bond log values is identified in this table by casing size, the nominal weight for each casing, and the estimated transient time in microsecond, and the expected free pipe reading. For any type of casing, you have a casing size, you have a nominal weight, also you have an estimated transient time, and also you have an expected for free pipe reading. So it's a very good important to have a log quality check or healthy check. This healthy check will identify what about the condition for the centralization, what about the fast formation, if you have a fast formation in your well, and also we have to define what about the cement condition, type of cement, borehole fluid, cement tops, hole size, and also the open hole caliber results, and also the deviated well. So you will estimate or determine the hydraulic isolation of cement. If you have a CBL VDL, you have to identify what about the different cases or different scenarios for CBL VDL. The first scenarios to have a very good cement, in this case, the CBL here will be low, and the VDL will identify the difference between the casing and cement and formation. The second type of results will be the poor cement bond quality. In this case, the CBL amplitude will be high, as this is the CBL response, and the VDL will not identify or not measure a contrast between the formation casing bond and also the cement casing bond. The fast formation, if you define a layer like anhydrite or any fast formation type, this formation have a great importance to focus on the CBL. CBL here will be high, and also the formation arrivals will be high. In this case, you have to identify the fast formation in your system to be aware that the CBL VDL is a limited in fast formation problem, and also is a limited in microannulus or micro debonded cement or cracks in cement. So the advanced tool of acoustic logs is the ultrasonic measurements. The ultrasonic measurements, like the echo ray and the heart check, this type of measurement is an osmosal evaluation of internal tubular thickness and solid bond to casing. Have a great benefits as it's well defined the full osmosal corrosion and also the annular evaluation solids settlement cement and formation swelling. And have also a very great benefits as it's less affected by the micro annulus cement than CBL VDL. But it have a great limitations with evaluation of lightweight cement and foam cement, and also have a great limitation with a poor hole fluid and well bore condition. In this type of log, you have to achieve the hole cleaning and the hole condition to very success and to very clean to achieve this look and get the more results from the advanced look of ultrasonic. The ultrasonic tool has a smoother casing coverage using a transducer. This transducer will rotate at the different type or different angles to scan or to image the status and the fluid identification. So the transducer here will rotate at approximately 7.5 RPS or revolution per second, and is fired 18 times every 20 degrees per revolution. So the ultrasonic tool have a great important to identify or to determine what about the image. So the cement images is very important. Also, the image of casing internal condition is very important. In this case, you have this transducer will define what about the mud, what about the cement, what about the formation. So the acoustic properties of materials as a very great factor to be identified in the ultrasonic log as the material with a certain density and certain velocity and certain acoustic have a certain acoustic impedance. Also you have to define that the ultrasonic imager will give you a great picture about the cement bond. This picture will identify it as a trend of good cementing. In this case, the color code or the color image will identify what about your case. If you have a red color, you have a gas. If you have a blue color, you have a water. If you have a green color, you have a green cement or contaminated cement. If you have a yellow to a brown color, you have a good cement. So in this case, if you have a poor cement, you don't show or you don't see here a very great color of yellow or brown color, but you see the green color is very great and the red color for gas channeling is very great. The second type or the second response of the ultrasonic image is the channel. The channel, in this case, you have to identify a cement quality, but not achieved at 100% of cross section around the casing and to the formation. Also, you have to define what about the gas channeling or what about the quality of cement not very accurate or not very success. The good cement here will identify the yellow color or brown color to identify your cement is very good and the integrity for your cement is achieved. And in this case, you have to identify that no requirement or no available squeeze cement or no need for squeeze cement. As we mentioned that the ultrasonic measurement have a great limitation with allied cement slurry or allied cement, allied with cement slurry. So the technology introduce advanced tool of isolation scanner. Isolation scanner depends on the smoothal evaluation of internal tubular thickness and solids bond, combining also the echo system or pulse echo in the ultrasonic and also a flexural mode or flexural measurement. The benefits of isolation scanner or this advanced tool is the evaluation of lightweight cement, also to identify the third echo interface processing, to identify the borehole shape and the casing centralizations. In isolation scanner, the image of your log will identify all around the casing, even you have a casing centralization problem. Also works in greater range of borehole conditions and thick casing. But it's have a great benefits to evaluate a lightweight cement and also a multi string or a multi casing. Like if you have a 958 and also you have a 7-inch liner, this gap this overlap between two types of casing have a great limitation with the CBL VDL also with the ultrasonic echo pulse system. But the isolation scanner in this case will work in a proper way. This is the application of isolation scanner to identify the light cement slurry. And this is the comparison between the ultrasonic tool MAB and the isolation scanner MAB. The isolation scanner MAB called is a solid liquid gas MAB. So the isolation scanner MAB can identify what about the difference between the solid and the liquid and the gas. And also will define what about the integrity and what about the hydraulic isolation barrier and what about the cement quality and what about the achievable parameters in your condition. Now, the common question when we are talking about the logging tools or when we are talking about the petrophysical methodology to identify the cement or job cement job quality and the integrity evaluation is what about the best logging tool to run? The best logging tool to run will depend on the objective of evaluation. If you have to identify a simple tube of cement only, you have to select or to utilize a CBL VDL. But if you have a channel and the gas problem, and also you have utilize a heavy weight cement or the normal type of cement, in this case, you have to use the ultrasonic imaging tool. In third case, if you have a contaminated gas and also you have a lightweight cement, in this case, you have to identify the two types. The two types is the ultrasonic imaging or isolation scanner. But if you stress or focus in a lightweight cement evaluation, and this lightweight cement evaluation have a weight less than 11 pound per gallon, or you have an eccentric casing problem or standoff for casing problem, in this case, you have to use the isolation scanner tool. So the best logging tool to run depends on the objective of evaluation and depends on your condition. And if you select the proper tool or proper logging tool, you will identify and determine the quality of cement in a proper way. And in this case, you will have an opportunity to take the best decision at the certain time. Thank you for this kind attention.